Hey everybody, welcome to the Brick Freaks. This is Phil and today I have a review for you of a steampunk mech from Winner. Model number is 8045/1375. Winner models always have two numbers and I don't know why. Anyway, steampunk mech. This is from the Steam Age theme. Winner has a couple of different themes. Frank already did, no he didn't do any of the themes, he did some technic pieces I think. But Winner also has the kids lines. I think technic is more for adults and the other lines from Winner are the ones I know are basically for kids. There's I think Jurassic World, which is battles with dinosaurs. Well, humans and dinosaurs fight other humans and dinosaurs, and there's also cars. I'm not sure. I have never built anything of those, but I've seen pictures and those look pretty nice as well. There's also a fantasy series, which is based on Journey to the... What direction is it? Journey to the West? The Monkey King thing? Well, that's also... So it's not Tolkien fantasy, it's Chinese or Asian fantasy. And then there's this, the Steam Age series. Let me just show you the back of the instruction manual. I hope this you can see this. The steampunk mech, or the steam machine as it's mostly called, is down on the in the left corner here. And there's also a few other cool sets. There's a flying shark helicopter thing, which the more I look at it, the more I like it. Also, there's a guy riding a mechanical wolf, I think, and some kind of steam engine, some tanks, and some helicopter flying things. I'm not sure. I think this is the least strange looking of the model sets, since it's a mech, and it's a steampunk mech, which is cool. I like mechs. I like steampunk. So this basically they made this one just for me. Well, most likely they made this thing for kids, but I'm in touch with my inner 8-year-old, and my inner 8-year-old told me this is for our collection, and I never argue with a guy. He knows what he's talking about. So enough digressing. It has too many figures. It has 371 pieces. Should retail around 15-16 euros, and it's a really nice set. Okay, first let me show you the minifigs, which are cool. Basically these are Lego minifigures, so if you live in a country where that is a problem, it's gonna be hard to get those past customs. Apart from that, well, the faces are a bit different, but that's all. Apart from that, they're very well done. Nicely printed arms, legs, torso, the front and the back, lots of metallic colors. Can you see? Yes, you see it shimmering. Well, okay, mostly that's the reflection from the lamp, but believe me, it's metal printing. The pirate dude on the left also has a gear for an eye, or maybe he's some kind of steampunk cyborg, I don't know. You can make up your own story. Let me turn these around so you can see the back prints. Everything nice here as well. These are two cool minifigures, seriously. But let's put those away so I can show you the mech, which is what you most likely want to see when you're watching this video. So, I'm sorry, this plate has a bit... I think I need to put some WD-40 on it or something. It's moving a bit rough. So, that mech is not... Oh well, it's a bit wobbly, of course, but this is... it's standing up. And as long as you don't have any major earthquakes, it should stay standing. It's actually very poseable, and it's pretty easy to keep it upright, which It's not something you can say about all Macs. I'm looking at you, Ninjago Max. So, I really like it. It's a nice build, some really nice ideas, and it looks suitably steampunky, I think, with lots of gears, levers, stuff you don't know what it's doing, a lot of exhaust ports, and I don't know. Steampunk is a strange genre. Okay. The quality of the bricks is very, very good. It's basically Lego. If they put Lego printing on this, I would believe it. Colors are also very nice, very close to the Lego ones. Also useful colors. Mostly gray, dark gray, or gunmetal gray, like here. Lots of brown for the wooden parts. Some black, some light gray. And some yellow for some nice accents, you can see. Here also on the side. Which really works. This thing was designed by somebody who knew what he or she was doing. Only drawback is everything you see that looks like a print is actually a sticker. I don't like stickers. I usually don't put them on, but in this case it looked really sad without them. But the problem with the stickers is that the colors don't match. Let me zoom in a little. So, I hope you can see that. You can see the here on the shoulder parts, the purple stickers. Well, these are supposed to be blue, as you can see on the instruction manual. I hope you can see it. Yes, you can see it pretty well, I think. See, they are supposed to be blue. They are purple. It's not too bad because the stickers cover the whole brick. If you apply them correctly, which now that I look at it, I fail to do. I guess you can also leave those two off. There are also two on the feet. Which have some dials on them, which I don't think you should leave off because I don't think it would look nice. What you should put on other wooden ones, because without it you lose a lot of the steampunk effect, because this machine is supposed to look like it was put together from cast iron, wood, and lots of gears, also some steam machine-y things and whatever. Seriously, I have no idea how this is supposed to work. But I don't have to. And the nice thing about steampunk is it's a genre where you actually shouldn't think too much about how it works, because it's basically supposed to look cool. Well, what else is there to say? As I said, the brick quality is really, really good. I was very happy with that. Everything holds together nicely and firmly, which is not a given with Chinese sets. Also the instructions are very, very nicely detailed, easy to follow. It's not the most challenging build in the world, but it's a kid's set, so what do you expect? And there's actually, except from the problem with the stickers, there's really nothing bad I have to say about this. I really like it. I like the design. I like the posability. I'm not going to show you now because I am still having a bit difficulty with my camera. But believe me, it's really poseable. It also stands up pretty well. I mean, you can bring it in any pose, and of course you can't sit it down, but who would sit a Mac down? Seriously. I like the ideas with the gears everywhere, and basically I like the idea of a steampunk Mac, which is something pretty original. loved it when I saw it and I had to have it, bought it, built it and still loved it. And it's gonna go back in my collection after this. And well, I hope you like it as well. If you have kids, this is a really nice sturdy set, which is not gonna lose pieces left and right. There are no stud shooters on this, there are no spring-loaded shooters or anything. It doesn't have any cool functions, so if you want something like that, this is not your model. But, well, if you really want something like that, you can mod it in using Lego parts. I actually don't like any of those things. Because, well, I'm not sure. I mean, it's obviously a machine built for war, but it doesn't have to shoot stuff around, I think. I like it. It's nice. It's my inner 8-year-old gives this a thumbs up. So, I'll put this back in my collection. Hope you liked the video. If you did, leave us a like. You can always subscribe. We are gonna do a lot of, usually 3 videos a week, I think, or more, depending on how busy we are. Well, basically most of them are gonna be Frank, but well, he is the original Brick Freak, so everybody else is just sitting in the cellar and sorting Lego pieces. We just are allowed to go up sometimes and do a review. So, leave a like if you liked it, subscribe if you liked it and want to see more of our reviews, leave a comment if you know if this is what this is, if this is a comic or a TV show or anything. You can inform me because I really would like to know. And well, see you next time. Have a great day. Bye.